Hello and welcome! Today I would like to compare these two gadgets and tell you my overall opinion on which one is better and why in the end of this video. The one made from aluminium alloy or the one made from plastic? I've been using both of them, the plastic one for about a year now and the other one for a few months. It is my personal opinion and I will never state that you need this gadget as in the end, you are the one who decides whether you will be using one or not. Before I begin, you can like or dislike the video as your opinion really matters to me and you can also subscribe to the channel if you would like to support it and see more fishing gadgets like these and know how to use them. I publish my videos twice a week, on Mondays and Thursdays. As always, from now on, I'll be putting a few links in the description. In this video, I'll put two where I bought these gadgets and two to Amazon so that you could compare the price. The quality of the tools is very similar, if not the same, but the price, well, you can have a look for yourself. If you'll decide to buy it where I did, you will need to wait for at least a month for the gadget to arrive. As you can see, these two gadgets are very similar and the process of tying hooks with them is the same. Let us have a look at the one made from aluminium alloy. As you can see, at the front it has this metal part which moves and something similar to a wheel which allows you to tighten and release these front jaws and the gold color looks very nice. At the back it has a bottom part which can be unscrewed and used for tying small hooks and making loops at the end of the line. I've already made a video on that and you can find it on my channel if you wish. Let me quickly do a demonstration how easily it is to tie hooks with it. First off, you need to release the jaws with the assistance of this wheel and put the hook between them. Tighten the jaws and make sure that this metal part is set to this position. Wrap the line around these two metal parts starting from the front and start rotating the tool while holding the tag end with your fingers. It might be not really comfortable to spin it if you do it for the first time, but after a few tries you will become an expert. You need to make at least 5 rotations to make a good knot and now the tag end goes around the metal part, which is closer to the jaws. Push the metal part down and pull the tool away from the main line so that this line would come off from the further metal piece onto the one you've just wrapped the line around. Release the jaws and remove the hook. Now just pull the tool away from the hook and that is it. The only thing that is left is to make the knot tight and cut unnecessary line. All is very simple and can be done in no time. Now let us have a look at the other gadget made from plastic, which was the first one I've bought. It also has a metal part at the front, the wheel which allows you to tighten and loosen these jaws. And what I really liked about it is that it has this bottom part which allows you to spin the tool around itself quite easily while tying hooks. One thing that was driving me crazy all the time when I was tying hooks with it are the jaws. On the aluminium one, the jaws hold the hook pretty tight, but on the plastic one, the hook might get loose while you are spinning it. I always had a thought that the one which I have received was damaged in some way inside, but who knows, it might be just mine and all the other ones work well. Also, When you try to tighten the hook between the jaws with this wheel and you spin it a bit harder, they will get loose, and you don't want that to happen. You see? That is exactly what I mean. It never happened to me with the aluminium one. In general, I would say that I would have picked the plastic one if not for the jaws, as it is very comfortable when you can spin it around itself and not the whole gadget as with the aluminium one. If the designers would find something similar to the aluminium one instead of this part with needles, I think that it would be one of the best hook tying tools out there. One thing that I have forgotten to mention is that these tools work for the smallest and for the biggest hooks and are affordable for all. Right now, I am using the aluminium one and will be using it in the future, but as I already said in the beginning, the choice is yours and now you know the main advantages and disadvantages of these two tools. If you have any questions, leave a comment under the video and I'll try to reply to all of them, and I really hope that the time you've spent watching this video was useful. You can also like or dislike the video, as your opinion really matters to me, and subscribe if you would like to see more interesting gadgets like these. I would also recommend you visiting fishmatpro.com website, where I share information about different fish species, lines, reels, rods, and a lot of other stuff. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.